second or third time.
Third time.
What are some of the other productions that you're actually planning to do in future, you know?
Well, in 2011, we actually have 6 productions at the theater here, or between 5 to 6 productions, all new concepts.
Okay.
Starting off, I have Dancing with the Legends 2, which is a new production that I started in 2010. It's another version of Dancing with the Legends, but it's the olden day version. So Dancing with the Legends is basically a show that highlights of all the very, very old songs. It's from the 1930s to the 1970s. Yes, and we hosted the first show at Sabaya in July this year, and it was phenomenal.
That's a Dance with the Legends.
Dancing with the Legends.
Okay.
So we have Dancing with the Legends Part 2 coming up in April next year. We're then doing something very different at East Meets West number 3. I've got some really, really, really creative ideas for this year's for next year's East Meets West. It's going to be something very different. I'm also looking at changing the entire concept and the entire look of the East Meets West fashion culture and dance show. I want to concentrate on more of the everyday designers, you know, the smaller retail design businesses, where you can actually, as an audience member, you can see somebody modeling the garment, and you know that you're going to walk into that store tomorrow and actually purchase the garment. The first two East Meets West were based on designers themselves, but I think for the third one, I want to try and target them to independent fashion stores. I also feel that in today's day and age, independent fashion stores have to compete against the bigger markets like Truett's and Edgar's, etc. And our independent stores, unfortunately, cannot carry the credit service that the huge stores offer. So they sort of work on a cash sort of basis. So I would like to also give them the exposure. Being somebody myself who likes to walk into a little independent store, see a little store in the corner, and be like, wow, there's some interesting stuff in there. I want to try and target that, try and give them a different look and get people to recognize the independent businesses with regards to fashion.
So you're actually giving back to businesses as part of your production?
You know, I do believe in that, because at the end of the day, we live in this town, we live in this city, and I train them and I give them a platform to learn about their culture. I give them a platform to try different things. I give them a platform where they're actually meeting people from different walks of life. I would also like to give back to those people who are like the same businesses, and businesses today are. So we're going through an up and down patch. I've spoken to a lot of fashion, you know, guys, and they keep coming back with, no, it's been good, it's been a bit quiet, and I need to get my name up there. So I thought, well, why not? And it's going to be something different and exciting. And I think the common man who comes to watch the show, I think they would also enjoy that, because like I said, they know they like that outfit, it's affordable. They can walk into the store and purchase the outfit. It's not where they have to go to the designer and get it designed and etc. etc. You know, it's ready made. So I want to try that and let's see how that pans out.
Okay, on Sleeping Beauty, you worked in partnership with somebody.
I think it was Hamtum.
Hamtum, you worked in partnership.
Was basically not my baby. I was just the production company that hosted it for them. Hamtum was a script that was written by a lady by the name of Shrivika. She was fresh out of campus and she had done the story on campus in her final year. And she loved the concept of Hamtum, which was a very real everyday story. It was situations that families and day-to-day people face in today's society. And she wanted to share that with the public. So as a production, London and Australia, about East Meets West, and they've seen on television. Last year, for the first time, Dance With Me Baby Part 2 was aired internationally, and again, the feedback was phenomenal. So I think Sony Television plays a very important part, in the sense is that they help me carry my brand and my passion to people across the world. So that for me is very, very exciting.
Interesting. Explain to me, how did this whole little thing with Vashon come along?
Vashon?
Yeah, I thought it was funny. Taking a radio guy, putting him on stage. How did that come about?
Well, I've always known Vashon Sukhan as the DJ, the afternoon show, knows everything and anything about Bollywood. When we first started off in East Meets West, when I opened up this company 5 years ago, obviously being new in the industry, me knowing that I have a passion for what I want to do, I have exciting ideas, and I know that I'm the sort of person who can do it properly. I really want to go out there and do it professionally. I want to give Indian theatre, Indian Bollywood theatre, a whole new look. I want it to look also auch mal classy and out there. So when I started off in the industry, we had the first production, and fashion was the first media person who gave me my very first interview to get it out to the public that this is what's happening. When nobody knew us and everybody was like, well, we're not sure about you, let's see how it goes. Fashion said, don't worry about it, Jumani. I didn't know him personally. He said, come along, I'm liking what you're telling me. I like your concept, it sounds interesting, come through, let's do an interview, let's see what happens. So he gave me my very first interview, I froze. We were on air doing an interview, and Bashi said, so when are you planning to get back into the dance studio? So I said, well, it was all a joke, and I said, well, Bashi, I'm waiting for you to join me. And this entire joke turned into something very serious, where eventually Varshan's station manager pulled me and said, listen, have you ever thought of maybe, let's try Varshan out? And I said, wow. You know what, I was just joking with him, but I would love to try it out. And Varshan was like, are you mad? I've never danced in my life. Well, I can't do what you guys just do. Come on.
Yeah.
Good try. So we managed to convince him. I must say he was an excellent sport. And surprisingly, it was not as difficult as I expected to actually teach him. I think he's also the sort of person who puts his mind to something. He focuses and he works at it. I had to get back onto stage after 7 years with him on stage. I performed at Dance With Me Baby Part 2. We had a lot of fun and it was amazing. The feedback we got was amazing.
Are you doing that again?
No. Dance With Me Baby the final. I'll be honest, I would love to.
Okay.
After I got back onto stage, I remembered what it was like to be on stage and I loved the energy.
Okay.
And I love the whole hype that happens on stage. I love telling the story of what's happening in the music.
Okay.
But unfortunately, there's too much of background work.
Okay, as far as dance goes and Bollywood, I think there are three people for me that like really stand out in the dance space. It's Govinda, it's Madhuri Dixit, and Hrithik Roshan.
Right.
Who in that space inspires you or inspired you when you first started?
To be very honest with you, I don't think I have a single role model. I have many role models.
Okay.
Bollywood for me has just been a passion since I've been very, very young. My sisters and I would watch Bollywood movies day and night. And every Sunday we would have to dress up and we'd sit my mom and dad here at Natal University.
Okay.
So I was living in Durban. My mom is originally from Durban, so we used to be here very often. All our holidays were spent in Durban.
Okay.
All our weekends were spent in Durban.
Yeah.
So I don't think that the move for me was very drastic, really. I have known Durban, I've always enjoyed Durban.
Mm-hmm.
But getting into the entertainment industry on the level that I have now, I started off with the Netbank Eastern Bride Affair as the choreographer, and I became a household name in Indian choreography from there. And then I just found that I had a lot more ideas and I had visions of different things that I wanted to incorporate and different things I wanted to share with the audiences. And up until today, I think my greatest pleasure of being in this industry is when I sit back and watch the audience say, wow.
Okay.
That for me is when I know job well done.
I can imagine.
That
one
for me is my greatest pleasure.
One final question. Your favorite Bollywood movie of all time?
Oh, that's so difficult.
I know.
That is so difficult. Oh, I have so many, but I think Kuch Kuch Hota Hai did it for me. And for me, I think the reason I would say that is because I know it was the typical love story,
yes,
and I know it was our typical favorite actors and actresses, but that for me, that movie was the first Bollywood movie that showed me the change of how Bollywood movies were made all along, and then Kuch Kuch came about, and for some reason, the effects, the clothing, the style of music, the hairstyles, everything just sort of changed, and I think Kuch Kuch actually started showing a different trend in how Bollywood movies would now fall in the new generations to come.
Okay.
So I think that's why it's held a very nice spot in my head. Also, Kuch Kuch Hota Hai, the first time I watched it, I think I cried for 12 hours even after the movie was over and the next morning. Yeah, it was
okay.
Fantastic.
Shivani, it was very nice talking to you. Thank you so much.
Lovely chatting to you too. Thank you very much.